the Malankara Orthodox Syrian Church. It became completely independent on 12 September 1912. But who was that person who actually led the church in those difficult times and built the church which is standing strong today? This holy saint was Saint Georgius Martinicus of Vattaseril, the Malankara Sabhabasuran or the great luminary of the church. Born on 31st October 1858 to Joseph Vattaseril of Malapalli and Eliamma as the fifth child, he, due to his faith, expertise in Syriac and theology and many contributions to the church working at various designations, went on to become the successor of polyglotal Joseph Martinicus V, Malankara Metropolitan. But before to know more about him, let's just know in brief about the Malankara Church's condition. Christianity had begun way back in AD 52 when Saint Thomas had landed in Kerala. He preached about Christ and his true way of living, but with the arrival of foreigners to India, they started interfering in the church matters. The impact and teachings were such that people were getting separated from the church. By the end of 18th century, when the church was in trouble due to these reformers, polyglotal Dionysius V sought help from the Patriarch of Antioch. Patriarch Peter III came to India by 1875. He called for Synod of Mulundarithi and divided the church into six dioceses and six bishops. By 1889, the legal fights with the reformers ended when the Royal Court of Travancore gave judgment in favor of the church. Court also gave judgment that Patriarch had got only the spiritual authority of the church and it would have no power over temporal matters. But Patriarch wasn't satisfied. The next patriarch, Patriarch Abdullah, claimed his authority in both spiritual and temporal matters. For that he came to Kerala by 1909 so that he can get the registered deeds from bishops and clergies to have the complete authority. But later he understood to have the registered deeds, Malankara Metropolitan should agree his perfect allegiance with the Patriarch. By 1909, Vattaseril thirumeni had been elevated as the Malankara Metropolitan and thirumeni strongly refused his demands. Patriarch felt humiliated with this. He threatened thirumeni and said that church won't be in peace and will see the bad days. To this he started by sending a letter of excommunication of thirumeni. The Malankara Metropolitan and the association ignored it and called for a meeting to resolve this problem. The church went to Royal Court and it gave the judgment in favor of thirumeni and thus his excommunication was stated as null and void. Syrian church at that time had a senior patriarch named Patriarch Abdetmashiho. Due to some internal politics in Turkey, the patriarch's power was made invalid in Turkey by the Sultan of Turkey. He was in support of us and also informed that the excommunication is null and void. Vattaseril thirumeni and his supporters requested the patriarch to come to Kerala to repair the damage done by Patriarch Abdullah. Thus, due to Vattaseril thirumeni's firm decisions and efforts, the Catholicate was established in the church. He consecrated Murimattathil Paulus Ivanius thirumeni as the first Catholicos, His Holiness Basilius Paulus I on the apostolic throne of St. Thomas at St. Mary's Church in Ernam. The Patriarch in his letter had stated that the new Catholicos was installed and the Episcopal Synod had the right to reinstall new one. The Catholicos has the right to consecrate new bishops independently and consecrate Holy Chrism or Holy Moron. The church had become independent, but thirumeni had to face lots of problems, physical and verbal abuses. The people who were supporting the patriarch were not satisfied and they made constant efforts to disrespect and kill thirumeni. They even hired a prostitute so that they can bring disrepute to his name. But all the plans failed as thirumeni's bodyguard Annapapi saw this and didn't allow her to enter the room. Thus, people who had gathered outside so that they can spread lies about thirumeni were outraged that the plans had failed. So they thought of eliminating him first. Thus, a group of 10 Antiochian extremists stabbed and murdered him to death on his way back from church. They even hired a goon Kamaluddin to kill thirumeni. When he entered into the room, he saw thirumeni kneeling down and praying. And he got so confused by seeing such a pious man that he went back without harming him. When he had got arrested, in a statement he had said that he had failed many times when trying to get into thirumeni's room. He felt as if some force was pulling his ladder down. God had saved Thirumeni many times due to his strong faith and complete dedication to God. The church arose in organizations and ashrams under his guidance. More Gregorious Orthodox Christian student movement had begun under his patronage. Thirumeni never wanted to stop relations with the Syrian church. He, in his old age, had went to Mardin in Turkey so as to meet Patriarch Elias III to maintain peace among the two churches. Thirumeni asked for cancellation of his excommunication to Patriarch Elias III. Being that it had already been cancelled by court, he did all this so as to maintain peace with the Jacobite Syrian church in India. Thirumeni had officially declared Malankara Church as Malankara Orthodox Syrian Church. In his last days too, he was involved in drafting the constitution of the church. He became physically sick by 13th February 1934 and became paralyzed by 16th February. On 23rd February 1934, he bid farewell to his earthly life and was buried on the next day at Old Seminary Chapel, Kottayam. His contributions to the church are unique. He is the architect of Indian Orthodox Church. For the stands he took on to bring autonomy to church, and due to various people's confessions about miracles happened in their life when they intercede to Vattaseril thirumeni, church decided to elevate thirumeni as a saint. On 24th February 2003, he was canonized by the Episcopal Synod headed by His Holiness Moranmar Basilius Marthoma Matthew II. Prayers and fasting were the pillars that were Vattaseril thirumeni's spiritual foundation. He faced all the challenges with the power he had gained through his valued spiritual life. As Moses had led the sons of Abraham from the captured land of Egypt to the promised land, but he himself couldn't enter it and could see it only through a distance. Likewise, the Moses of Malankara Church, Vattaseril thirumeni, had led his people and could only see the freedom of his church from a distance. In our church history, there would be no one who had suffered so much torture and pain like thirumeni did. He lived and fought for the freedom of Malankara Church, founded by St. Thomas, and we are indeed indebted to him. May his prayers be there for us always.